pot-caught crab from the inshore fishery is one of the most sustainable fish from our own shores that you could possibly think of. And we're going to make some really nice handmade crab ravioli with it. Really simple, emphasis on the crab, delicious flavour, little herb butter to finish. First things first, we need to make some pasta. Start off with some flour, make a little well. You can use a mixture of plain flour and bread flour. You can get away with pretty much any flour you like, but this is a nice white spelt flour. It gives a really soft pasta. So you start with one whole egg, and then we're gonna add a couple of egg yolks. Separate this one. And once you've got this little setup on the go, you've got to be quite bold. So, take your fingers, like that. One thumb and three fingers pointing down to make a sort of whisk. So we just mix that together like that. And we're just going to work that now to make it really smooth, really strong. And a little bit of pasta like that might not look very much, but when we roll this out, turn it into ravioli, easily going to be a nice two portions. But before we can roll that out, we need to just let it rest, probably in the fridge, wrapped in cling film for 10-15 minutes. So once you've cooked and picked your crab, you end up with some nice brown meat and some beautiful sweet white meat, and together they give you a really rich flavour. So as the filling for my ravioli, all I'm going to do is season that with a little bit of pepper. I won't put any salt in there, because it'll be quite salty already. It's a naturally salty thing. So that's the filling made, which was easy. All we've got to do now is grab the pasta that's resting in the fridge, roll it out, and make some ravioli. We're gonna just divide that in half, so that we've got half for the top sheet, half for the bottom. And roll them out one bit at a time. Nice and thin, like that. Roll out the other half. Once you've got both pieces nice and thin, you can put one on a nice floured surface, and that's going to be the bottom. And then the other piece, obviously, is going to go over the top to make the raviolis. But all we need to do is pop our filling onto here. About a teaspoonful, something like that. Not too close together, we've got to cut them into ravioli. Great, just need to put the top on. I'm just going to lay that on the top, flatten my ravioli slightly, and then just going to go around each single one, starting at the front and working towards myself to exclude the air. If we get too much air in there, as you put them in the water, they'll start to float, and then they'll only cook on one side. All we need then is a pasta wheel to cut between them. Now, if you haven't got one of these, you can use a knife. And all these little bits of pasta, they don't get wasted. We can cut them out, use them for a different pasta dish, or dry them and use them at a later date. They all look quite happy in there. We'll let them cook until the pasta's tender. In the meantime, I'm gonna pop this pan on a low heat, ready to make our nice thyme butter. Chuck a bit of butter in there. Nice. Just tear a few thyme leaves straight off in there. So thyme and butter just starting to bubble. Time that perfectly, because we're gonna have the raviolis going straight in, and we're not gonna drain them too much. We want a little bit of water on there, because that's gonna mix with the butter in here in the thyme and emulsify a little bit. So let's go for it. those over in there. A little bit. A little bit more pepper. And a little squeeze of lemon juice in there. Just to sharpen it all up. Cut through that butter. Lovely. Just coated nicely in that. Let's plate a few of these up. There you go. Crab, fresh pasta ravioli, made easy.